Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'm teaching an absolute beginner's lesson on how to manually animate a mask using keyframes in DaVinci Resolve.
There you go. Oh, thank you. You're welcome.
Before we get started, please do me a favor and hit that like button, and if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe to the channel for more content like this. So in Resolve, I'm going to manually animate a mask using keyframes to create this interacting clones effect. So if I come up here to my media pool and I select this icon, which is source tape, then you can see that I have this one long video where I start by making this water, taking it over.
There you go.
Saying that, waiting for response.
Welcome.
And then saying that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just set an in point there using the key I on my keyboard, and then set an out point there using the key O. Then I will just drag this down here onto my editor timeline, and you can see this is where I say, there you go, and this is where I say, well, you're welcome. Back to the source tape. Now I'm sitting here and I say,
oh, thank you.
And then I go ahead and pick up the water and start drinking it, right? So I film this all in once. So now I'm just going to set an in point here and I'll set an out point there. And then I will drag this down on top. And the key here is that you can see where this happens in between, and I'll just slide this. So now the whole thing looks like this.
There you go. Oh, thank you. Welcome.
Perfect. Okay. And let me just tighten this up to here so that I can expand that later, right? But this is the important part. Now, if I grab this top layer, it is covering this bottom layer off. Oh, and by the way, let me just turn those off so that I can scrub through here without having a problem. What I'm going to do is come over here to the inspector panel, and under opacity, I'm going to change that to 50%. And so now you can see the interaction. I set that cup down and then I grab it and pick it up there, right? The problem is of course the cup is already there on this top layer. So we're going to mask that cup out. And then we're going to move that mask as soon as I remove my hand from it, revealing the cup. So to do that, I'm going to come over here to the color page. And with this node selected, we're going to click on the power window icon here. And we're going to use this pen tool to do this. All right. So selecting that, I will use my mouse wheel to roll out here. And I'm just going to click here, click where the cup is, click up here, and then close the mask this way, right? So now that this half, and you can see how this half of the mask is working, but I need to go ahead and plug it in. So I'm going to right click and say add alpha output to add the alpha output, and then I will go ahead and connect the alpha transparency information to that. Back in the edit page, I'm going to go ahead and increase that to 100. And now you can see where that mask is, and you can see both sides of this. Back here in the color page, what I'm going to do is, right now we have the parade scope selected, and that's this key, but if I come over here, this is the keyframes, and I'm going to select that. And what I will do is, right after, I'm just going to move this playhead forward, right as I start to remove my hand, that's where I want that keyframe to start. Okay. Oh, by the way, before I begin, I do want to go ahead and soften this edge, because if I don't, then there'll be an obvious cut line there. So now that I've found that, I'm going to click on keyframe, setting keyframes on all, everything with regard to this mask. And now I can just drag this over here and it sets a keyframe for me there. Then if I move the playhead forward, I wait all the way until I go to reach with my other hand. And now I'm going to drag this over here. So this sets another keyframe down here. And now that moves across as I'm having that little interaction, and it is revealing the cup that was already there so that I can reach out and grab that. So now when I come back to the edit page, you can see that this works out really nicely. So here's this, and then the little interaction happens, and the mask is sliding over, and there you go. And that's how it works. It's really that simple. I'm Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and this has been an absolute beginner's lesson on manually animating a mask using keyframes in DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to be doing a lot more tutorials on masking, so like this video and subscribe to the channel so you won't miss any of those. In the meantime, here's a playlist of all the Resolve tutorials that I've made so far. Thanks for watching.
There you go. Oh, thank you.